W228CG Warwick is 93.5 FM WTBQ.
Break to it.
On the go, go.
We're going to go to the game show now, but tune in at 11 a.m. for Joe Dan's on creativity and technology, and let's see what the PC stuff is all about at these colleges,
right,
which is a reflection on everything else.
All right, Joe, thank you. Joe. Hey, you know, it's interesting because King Tut, I mean, how can that be?
I don't want to even talk about it anymore. It's just annoying beyond belief. I will never be PC. If you don't like it, don't listen. I'm good. It's just, I'm done with it. We don't have any genius comedians anymore. Just done. But anyway, we do have Joe Liguori here. Now, what are we playing today, TattleTaylors?
We've got TattleTaylors round two today.
Okay, round two, Frank.
Okay.
All right.
I like that.
We need our music.
King Tut, you need our music?
Yeah, I got to have that.
Cue the music. All right.
I don't know why I love that music.
That's great.
All right, let's do it.
All righty. So this is TattleTaylors round two. Taylor, you won the last game.
Of course,
so let's see if Frank can catch up a little bit.
I'll put my thinking cap.
You need more than a cap.
Here's our first question. One pointer here. Is your favorite vacation spot north, south, east, or west of here? Favorite vacation spot.
For me, right?
North,
no, for
south,
both of
east,
us.
Or west. You write down your own answer there.
It's easy.
Taylor, what's your favorite? You write that down.
South.
Frank, what's your...
Well, no, wait. I didn't even get to answer yours yet.
We're both going to do south.
Yeah, right. South, yeah.
We go to the shore every year.
Point for each of you. All right. 1-1, tie score. Two-point question coming at you. What food do you pile way too much of on your Thanksgiving plate?
Well,
that's a good thought.
Am I answering for me or for Frank?
For you.
Each
yourself.
To yourself.
Let me see what I pile on.
Oh, you do? Well, let me think about this.
All right. Write them down.
Yeah, because she don't know. Because it's her food, and I can't eat that stuff.
What?
No, I'm just saying.
You will not have dinner Thanksgiving.
I better check my food.
Better check more than that.
Let's see. What do I pile on the plate? I pile everything on the plate, so I'm trying to figure out which one I pile more on the plate than anything else. Way too much of. Deb.
All right, you got him?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, Taylor. What does Frank pile way too much of on his Thanksgiving plate?
Well, everything, but I have to pick one.
Yeah.
I'm going to say turkey.
Turkey. And that's it.
Yeah. Although it's a close second, third, and fourth for everything else. You know, mashed potatoes, tons of it, you know.
I happen to be a great cook. He's just teasing.
Yeah, it's just that she cooks differently than the Thanksgiving I grew up with, where we went out by the old outhouse, and we got ourselves a real turkey.
Yeah, a can of cranberries,
right, everything has to be canned.
Everything with me is fresh and homemade.
Yeah, I can't eat that fresh stuff. My body just can't take it, Taylor. I can't.
All right. What did I write?
All right,
what do you pile too much of on your plate? Well, it ain't turkey, that's for sure. Let's see. What does she pile the most on the plate? You see, this is hard, because Taylor, when it comes to a food question, Taylor doesn't eat anything. So I'm going to just say stuffing.
I don't eat stuffing. It's got sausage in it.
Yep. Then, see, she doesn't eat anything. She piles nothing on her plate. All right, what is the answer, Taylor?
Potatoes.
You know how I make them. So I cook my potatoes in milk.
Yeah, I slip bacon in there while you're not looking.
Yeah, okay. All right, go ahead.
Does most of that food end up clogging down the drain? Or
no,
does
it doesn't go down there. It goes down Frank's stomach.
There you go. All righty. Question three, 3 points. What was your last impulse buy? What was your last impulse buy?
What was my last impulse buy? I'm not an impulse
Me
buyer,
either.
But I do that occasionally.
It does happen.
That's interesting.
Wow. Isn't that funny?
Yeah, because I don't buy anything on impulse. So
you know why? We're getting too old. That's why.
No, we don't impulsively buy anything anymore.
That looks really good.
I've never been that way. I buy when I have to.
I used to do retail. You always put the items that you impulse buy right near the front when you come in. I just walk past that now, and I go, I ain't going to buy any of that.
I'm not an impulse buyer, so I wouldn't, not any time in my life. So I'm trying to think.
Oh, I'm sure I know. Well, I know what you would buy, but let me think what I would buy.
What I would buy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Frank, so you got your answer?
No, not yet. Hold on. I got to do a little thinking cap thing here. I don't think I did anything this year on an impulse buy. It's weird, but I'm just going to write this down because it is true. It is an impulse buy. Could be. Okay. Go ahead, Taylor. What is the last impulse buy I bought?
What was the last impulse buy that Frank bought?
It had to be something from Home Depot.
That's actually a really smart idea.
Yeah, because that's the only
place he goes to buy. Yeah.
I'm going to say some wood. I don't know.
Wood, yeah. Hey, that looks like some nice wood over there. Wouldn't that look just great in the back of my car?
I don't know what you're
gonna have it.
I gotta use that. No, I don't buy anything.
I don't know.
When I go into Home Depot, you know, I have my list of what I'm buying, and that's, right, and I so stick what, to it. By the way,
part?
I just want to know. I heard a commercial the other day for Home Depot to come on out and shop for the holidays. What are you going to buy at Home Depot for the holidays?
Christmas trees, lights.
That's not shopping for the holidays. Yeah. They're talking about gift giving.
Oh, gift giving. Now, well, they have a million things you can give
for guys.
Tools.
Yeah,
but you already got tools. You know, other than tools, what else are you going to buy at Home Depot? What am I going to buy? You know, they do sell washers and dryers,
right,
but you don't buy that for the holidays. That's not usually a gift, personal gift.
Don't ever buy a woman a
There's nothing
vacuum
in Home
Depot.
I'm trying to think, what could you buy in a Home Depot that a woman would really say, the wood, right? That's nice cherry wood you bought over there. What are we going to do with it?
I don't know what
You know, there's really not, it's like the
I
least
think
shopping.
I appreciate a nice hammer.
Yeah, a hammer. Put the hammer down.
I can beat you over the head with it.
Yeah, so I mean, even for a guy, it's kind of like, you know, tools are a personal thing. I don't mind you buying me tools.
Oh, my God. Tools are
No.
Tools are a personal...
You got to get the right... It's got to fit the grip. It's got to be right.
All right.
I said, believe it or not, it was dessert, because I'm always trying to decide.
Dessert.
And I don't want to buy dessert. And sometimes impulsively buy...
Pecan pie.
Pecan pie. Was it dessert the other day?
We were at Shannon's Eyes on the
Impulse.
Pies.
Impulse.
You're right.
We were at Shannon's Eyes on the Pies in in Warwick. And we saw pies there, and I said, I'll take this, that. And it was a dessert.
And it was delicious.
It was.
All right, what did I say?
All right, Frank,
say?
A chance to take the lead.
What did Taylor say?
What was
I would say something with cosmetics.
You're right, makeup.
Wow.
Yeah. I see all these packages arriving every day. The mailmen have worn a path to the front door here. There's so many boxes going out here, we don't have room for the recycling right now.
Okay.
All right, Frank, you just took the lead. Here's a four-point question.
I thought it was 1-1.
No, this was a three-point question.
4-3.
I go for the gold here.
That's right.
Four-point question. What is, or would be, the first thing on your bucket list currently? First thing on your bucket list.
Something you always wanted to do.
Person to meet. Place to go.
Anything at all.
I'm trying to think which one now.
Number one on that list.
Interesting, yeah, because we usually do what we want to do, but there are some things on the bucket list that, you know, I'd like to do.
Okay.
All right. What do you got there, Taylor?
All righty. Frank, what is her number one item on her bucket list?
He's never going to get it.
Probably to adopt more pets.
I would love to do that, but that's not going to happen.
I don't know. What is it?
What is it, Taylor?
I put either Talladega or Daytona.
Oh,
wow.
Interesting.
Wow.
Yeah, that would be cool.
You've done so many things, but that's one I guess.
Yeah, what would be mine then?
All right, what's Frank's?
I would think
list?
It was going to be Talladega or Daytona 500, but let me think about that.
Number one,
it has to be
a
car, something with a car.
Yeah, but what though?
Possibly.
You got to be specific.
I know,
possibly.
I know. He wants a buy. I don't know if it's a super bird you'd want first, or you know, I know you.
Yeah,
want
all
to
I'd have
it.
To do is rob about four banks to be able to get the money to that thing.
But that's not what he's saying. What's on your bucket
list? On a bucket list, yeah. Well, bucket list usually things to do and not things to buy.
Okay, so...
Like dessert.
No, it's not dessert. Bucket list, what would you like to do on the bucket
Number
list?
One thing.
I'm not sure what you'd like to do on the bucket list.
Kind of funny, because you don't realize that until you sit down and think about it, you know, because I never really thought...
No, we never talk about it. We do everything we want to do.
Yeah, my bucket list is...
I'm going to say maybe drive the pace car.
You know, that's pretty darn close, though. I just said, you know how they have those classes where you can learn to drive the NASCAR around the track?
Well, that's what it is. So pace car is a NASCAR.
All right.
All right, so...
We'll give it to you.
I hate to say that, but yeah, it's close enough.
All right. Current score is 7-4. This is a 5-point question.
We're there.
Here's the big one.
Here's
now, I want to explain. Listen carefully now. This is a little bit different.
All right.
You're going to write down for your partner here. I'm going to read the question. What bird would you say?
Partner.
What bird would you say best describes your partner? What bird?
Oh boy.
There's
a dirty bird? A
couple good answers here.
Nah, there's an easy one for Taylor.
So you're going to write down for your partner there.
All right.
What kind of bird?
Yeah.
You could get real funny
I'm
with
done.
This.
I'm done.
I'm already done. I'm
He's
in.
Got
I'm
it.
In the zone.
Oh.
She's questioning.
Yours easy.
What kind of bird would
best describes
me?
Your partner?
My partner?
Yes.
Yeah,
oh.
not you.
What
oh,
what bird
okay.
best describes Frank? Frank wrote, what bird best describes you?
I know what she's going to write down.
All right. Frank, what bird best describes Taylor?
Oh.
I'm sorry. What bird does best describes you?
It would have to be a vulture.
Yeah, I wrote dodo.
Dodo. Oh, that's really funny. I thought it was the way I eat.
All right, Taylor, what bird best describes Frank? I'm sorry, describes you.
Gee, me. That was fun. Best describes me, I would say...
What does Frank think there?
An eagle.
No, because, and I actually called her this several times over the last couple of weeks, because, see, with Taylor, it's always like, you know, like, where were you 5 minutes ago? What took you so long to get, where were you, how come it took you so long to get here? So she watches me like a hawk.
Oh, that's a good one.
It's true. And I said to her, I said, what are you, you're watching me like a hawk. You know, what are you doing? Where you been? What's going on?
I've never heard you say that, but okay.
All right,
Taylor, you're the winner.
Yay, you can't win.